What's up? I'm Morris, playing Blood Incantation.
Hey, this is Jeff Barrett.
And this is Isaac Falk.
It's Paul Riedel from Blood Incantation here at Amoeba in Hollywood. We're doing What's in My Bag.
So, yeah, I found this CD. It's a Fate's Warning, Perfect Symmetry. It's the album they did right around the time of another album, Parallels, where they had a new singer. This is where this band really started going in the progressive direction, where very extended like solo sections and odd time signatures and stuff like that. And yeah, very influential. Actually, parts of this were very influential on Hidden History of the Human Race when we were working on that.
First thing in my bag is Morbid Angel's 1999 album, Formulas Fatal to the Flesh. I don't own this on vinyl. I think this is the second repress. Huge influence on Blood Incantation, if you can tell. One of our favorite records. And it's good to find it here.
Yeah, total classic.
The first thing I found was in the New Arrivals bin. It's the 90s reissue of the second Wallenstein album. Classic krautrock on the Pills label. Great psychedelic prog krautrock with a little bit of folk and kind of symphonic aspect. Killer.
And a great cover.
Yeah, uh-huh. Mother Universe.
First thing I picked out, I went straight to the jazz section to find this record that changed my life. I got to see Dave Brubeck before he died when I was about 17 in New Jersey. The saxophone player on this, Paul Desmond, is also one of my favorite jazz players. Super important record to me and my dad, actually, growing up. It's a very cool thing.
My next thing is this Osamu Kitajima album. I have not heard this one, but I'm a really big fan of his stuff from the 70s and 80s. And this album has a 12-minute song, so I'm guessing it's gonna be pretty cool. I just wanna read the back of this because this was like really interesting to me. It says, higher octave music is founded upon the vision that we have entered an era of global cooperation and unity in which music plays an integral part. Our purpose is to help set a new standard of excellence in the music of this era. We are dedicated to a process of continuous refinement, both artistically and commercially. As in music, so in life. I was like, that sounds great. I'm gonna buy that.
Next, I got the Carlos Santana, John McLaughlin record, Love, Devotion, Surrender. Morris picked it up at another record store on this tour. They're two amazing guitarists that I love both of their solo works, so I'd like to see them work together.
Next is a record I have not heard, but was apparently unavailable on official format until this reissue from Wawa, but Bernard Zolotol is like a classic new age type of progressive electronics guy, a lot of Terry Riley style tape loops rather than like, you know, harsh digital sequencers and synthesizer stuff. So I have a couple of records from this guy. I never heard this one. It includes a bonus 7-inch. There's also a song called Gliding Through the Cosmophonic Dome, so it's probably great.
Next up, I got quite a lot in here. Steve Hillage. Rainbow Dome music.
This is the Dome Zone.
This is the Dome Zone. This is ambient electronic record from Steve Hillage, who is widely known for his guitar playing in Gong and Khan and his solo project with his wife, which is now electronic music. But this guy is a legendary shredder. Think George Harrison, but even more psychedelic and just like ripping. Great, great album.
Next on in my bag is this LP by Abigor. It's Leitmotif Lucifer. One of my favorite bands. I love every era of this band. They started as like super raw, like medieval black metal, and then evolved into this like really complex, insane kind of technical, extreme music rooted in black metal. So super stoked about that. Says Steph Pick too, so good taste, y'all.
Next, I got Tears for Fears' 1989 album, The Seeds of Love. This one is super psychedelic. They basically were like, all right, we're the Beatles now, and are making extremely layered and psychedelic music. It's a classic record that we listen to on tour all the time, and I haven't been able to find an original pressing in decent enough shape to warrant buying, so this repress will have to fill the hole.
This is one of my favorite records also. It's awesome. I bought this on our last tour in Europe, actually. It's super, super good.
Next one I have not heard. It's Pauline Anastrom. This is a very early electronic synthesis. She's actually blind, so there's a very particular type of subtlety to her home recordings from the 70s and 80s. This is her first new album. I think she died a few years ago, and this is her first new album in over 30 years, so why not?
This is a record by Yukihiro Takahashi. He was one of the members of Yellow Magic Orchestra in Japan, pretty much Japanese Kraftwerk. His solo stuff is a lot like New Order, but like on the darker, really deep, rich sounding side. I haven't heard this album, but Neuromantic is one of his greatest records, and this came out shortly after that, so I'm certain it's gonna be great. Also, on Yen Records, which is a great, just like New Age and electronic label from Japan in the 80s. What do I have to do
for you to rescue me? Still got a couple more in here. I found this record by XTC, English Settlement. I'm almost at completing my collection. This is one more. I think I only have one or two more to get. Yeah, this is one of my favorite bands. I kind of consider them like basically the Beatles of the 80s. And this was one that I neglected to buy just because it's like super heavy on the Andy Partridge songs, which, you know, it's still very good. So I was excited to see it, and I'm glad I got it.
Soundtrack to one of my favorite animes of all time, Cowboy Bebop. I have no idea what pressing this is. It looks fairly new. Yeah, 2020. You can't beat space jazz. And the Seatbelts are seriously insanely talented. I don't know. It's one of the best soundtracks of any anime, for sure.
Absolutely.
This is another obscure New Age thing, Karma Moffat, gotta give a shout out to. Legendary Bay Area, singing bowls, like, you know, Tibetan mantras, breathwork, synthesizer, bells, type of New Age musician, 70s and 80s. Morning Trip, one of the greatest archival reissue labels in history. Karma actually did the album cover for my first solo album coming out in the end of the year called Ocean of Peace. Keep an eye out for that if you like this type of chill shit. But he's like a visionary, transcendental, new age artist. And this one is Sitting Still Within, Sitting Still Without. You know what I mean? How can you go wrong? Look at that, you know? So it sounds exactly like this looks like, so.
Got this first album by the Eurythmics, In the Garden, produced by Connie Plank. This does not sound like the Eurythmics that you're thinking of. It's way more stripped down, post-punk style, super catchy, really minimal.
Really ethereal.
Very ethereal. This is a reissue from 2018, but even this is getting harder to find these days, let alone the OG pressing, so I'm pretty stoked to have found it.
My prize for the day is this album by Agong called Angel's Egg, which is one of my all-time favorite progressive rock albums by one of my all-time favorite progressive rock bands. This was a band that had Steve Hillage and David Allen and all these guys from the UK progressive rock scene that then moved to France and just started doing a bunch of acid and lived on this like compound where they started working on music like this. It's the perfect lineup. Tons of synths, tons of crazy improvisation, jazz and like psychedelic rock and all that stuff. So super stoked to get an original pressing. I have the reissue from a few years ago, but this is the real deal. So very excited about that.
Last thing in my bag is this 1981 Michael Stern's Planetary Unfolding. He was a new age artist from Tucson, Arizona that moved up to Santa Fe and was involved in the new age and ambient scenes in Southern California as well. This is a huge influence on Blood Incantation as well, obviously, for Time Wave Zero and all of our other stuff.
This was a big one for me today. I was actually deliberately looking for this, hoping you guys would have it. It's Klaus Schulze's last record, released posthumously after his death, RIP. Complete legend, total master. We wouldn't be here without him today. Massive influence on Time Wave Zero, obviously. This is a Deus Arrakis, I guess it's like Dune-themed record. It's honestly one of his best works.
Easily. Top five, Klaus Schulze.
Up there with all the 70s stuff.
No question. It's incredible.
Completely immersive. Yeah, this is an import, so I'm really glad you guys had it. Super immersive, highly recommend. Everyone that's having a stressful day goes home, chills out, puts this on. It'll help you out.
It's a masterpiece. Speaking of masterpieces, this band has like 10. I've never heard this one. Eloy from Germany. Metromania, 1984. All the 70s stuff is incredible. This nice textured cover on Heavy Metal Worldwide, they did a lot. They did like the Amoebics Monolith and stuff like that.
The Scorpions.
First album, you know, so. I don't know. Also, a little expensive for an Eloy record, so I'm expecting it to be really good. Because they're usually extremely cheap, because they're just, you know, they get made fun of because of their really thick cologne accents, but it's so good.
This is another thing I've been eyeing online, a recent reissue of Candlemass's first record. This is the box set edition from Peaceville, with a bunch of early demos, stories as to how the record came to be, one of the most important metal records in history, in my opinion, and an introduction to, you know, essentially doom and death doom for me. The singer left after this record and was replaced by the more popular Messiah, although he is now back, and they are killing it live. You get the chance to go see them. They don't only play songs off of this record, they do Messiah-era stuff too. It's awesome, and yeah, really happy to have found this in person because I almost bought this online numerous times before we left the tour.
You guys don't happen to have another one, do you?
So, we'll take a look.
We'll check.
Awesome. Thank you both so much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thanks for having us.
Amoeba!